Hey you and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry. In this little video, I'm going to be going over some of the shortcuts that we use on Chromebooks. Now, Chromebooks can be very, very useful and actually handy in work, play, and entertainment. For example, my whole family uses Chromebooks to do games, watch videos, movies, stuff like that. And I use it to create my lessons and other work there. So they can be very useful. The thing is, they are different than Windows. And many people go into the Chromebook world, they get their new Chromebook, they go, all right, high security and everything else about it, right? And it's supposed to be really quick. And then their expectations is that it's going to be identical to a Windows machine. Well, the reality is, it's very, very different. Apps are installed from either the Play Store or the Chrome Web Store. That's where you get your apps. And there are millions of apps there now, so you should be able to find everything that you need, even Microsoft Word, which is an online app. The ones I use to edit office documents would be actually Google Docs and Google Sheets, Google Drive. Those are the apps that I mainly use to actually edit my Microsoft Office documents. So there is a little bit of getting used to the different user interface and everything else there, but as soon as you get used to everything, Chromebooks can be very, very useful and I think enjoyable as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over some of the shortcuts that I use in my Chromebook and that I think new users of Chromebooks should know. Alrighty, so let's get into it. What are the useful shortcuts that we use in my Chromebook? Well, here we are in my Chromebook, and so I'm going to talk about those shortcuts right now. If we look at the bottom of my screen, we see the shelf. That's that black line that you see there. The very first icon there is my launcher. If I click on my launcher and I click on the little carrot there, it reveals my apps that I've installed. Now let's say that you just got your Chromebook and you go, all right, I got my Chromebook, and you don't see any of these apps, right? You just see maybe a handful of apps there, or maybe not even a handful there. So the very first one there is the Play Store. That's where you can find more apps, such as if you wanted to do Microsoft Office, that works online, by the way. It can be found in the Play Store. Another one there that we use is the Web Store. We can find other apps and extensions that work there within your Chromebook. Many of these apps work offline. That, not all of them, but many of them do. So many games, many of the Office apps that I use, any work offline. So they say, well, which Office apps do I use that actually work offline? Maybe I'm somewhere on a trip someplace. Well, the apps that I use would be Google Drive, Google Docs, Google Sheets. Those are the ones I use a lot in creating these lessons that you're seeing right now. And they work offline, and I can find them there at the Web Store or at the Play Store there if you wanted that. But normally I use the Web Store for those. All right. Another thing that you notice is at the bottom of my shelf, you see all these apps are just, they're parked down there. Well, how do you pin your apps down there? Well, let's go down and actually look at some of the apps that I have. The very first one you see over there is Pluto TV. If I right-click Pluto TV, notice I have open. And then right below that, I have pinned to the shelf. So that's the second option, and that's how you pin it to the shelf. So if I actually choose that option, boom, it appears down at the bottom there of my screen. And it'll be there, easy way for you to find it. Now, let's say for some reason that you don't want one of these apps. You know, you've used it for a little bit, and you go, I'm not really excited about this app. Right-click it, and you have uninstall is the option there. It's the third option there. Just uninstall it. It comes off of your Chromebook. Many questions come up about this. I actually have discrete videos on all of these things here. But many times people ask me, they say, hey, Mr. Barry, I can't uninstall a particular app. And I said, well, which one is it? And they go, well, it's the Play Store. Well, guess what? If I right-click it, that is not an option. And the reason why we cannot uninstall the Play Store or some of the other apps is because they're an integrated part of the operating system. The Chrome OS, in order for it to work properly, it has to have particular apps there working in the background. The Play Store is one of them, and you just can't uninstall it in the normal way. All right, so if you right click an app and it does not have the option for uninstall, just know right away, oh, that's a Chrome OS app. It's a necessity and you can't take it off. Let's say one of these others, like this game here, I didn't want the game anymore, right click it, and I have uninstall is an option there. So choose that and it'll actually remove it from your Chrome account. Another thing that I find rather useful in Chromebooks is, let's say something happens to this Chromebook. No worries, I simply get another Chromebook, log into my Google account, and all my apps that I've installed on the first Chromebook and all the data and stuff like that will be transferred over to the second Chromebook, which is kind of nice. So again, the apps come over. Now, if you've downloaded data onto a particular Chromebook and you haven't saved it or haven't backed it up into your Google Drive, that information would be lost. So you want to make sure that you do back up your data to your Google Drive. But guess what? That's usually an automatic thing. And Google Drive is one of those apps that actually comes pre-installed on your Chromebook. I do have other apps, or other videos, I should say, that actually go into the details of how to use Google Drive and make it very, very useful. For example, let's say that right here we're at the home screen, right? We're at google.com. If you look right above me, you'll notice these, it looks almost like a Rubik's Cube of squares. That is your Chrome apps or your Google apps. If you click it, you'll see YouTube, Gmail, and a few of the others there. The one that I use most often would be the Google Drive. So I'm going to click on the Google Drive, and you notice that the Google Drive opens up, and you find all of your applications, all of your documents are there. If you go into the settings right here, it looks kind of like a gear right there. If you click on the gear, that's how you find your settings. And you can actually turn on the option to make Google Drive work offline. So basically it makes a copy of all of your data, your documents, that type of thing that you use within Google Drive, and it puts it right onto your Chromebook, so that if you're taking a long trip and you need those the documents or other files, it could even be videos and stuff like that, onto your machine, that's how you do that. So notice that you have right there, it says offline, and that's how you enable offline support for your Chromebook. Once you have that checked mark, then you click on done, and you give your computer a few minutes really to download all of the documents and your files that you may have saved in your Google Drive. And that is something that it does in the background automatically, so you don't have to be manually copying and pasting your files back and forth like you did back in the old days when we used to use Windows machines. Another really handy thing about the shortcuts is, if you are working with the Chromebook and you're brand new to it, you've probably used a Windows machine or other kinds of computers in the past. And one of the shortcuts that we use quite often is Control C for copy and Control V for paste. I use that a great deal when I'm working, creating my lessons on my Chromebook, or even when I'm making these videos. By the way, just to let you know, I'm using the Chromebook right now to create this video, so it is a very useful device. Now, how do we open up and see the shortcuts that are pertaining to the Chromebook? The shortcut is Control Alt question mark. There it is, and it opens up all of your shortcuts. And I'm going to go over some of the questions that really come up quite often with the shortcuts. People get a Chromebook, and one of the first things they look down, they go, hey, where's my caps lock key? Well, that's easy. Just go Alt and then search, and it will bring up the caps lock. So now if I key in something here like help, it's all caps, right? So that's how you do all caps. How do you turn it off? It's Alt search again, and it turns off the caps lock option there. All right. Another shortcut that I use quite often, if I just click on that search key, it opens up my launcher. So that's another shortcut that I use quite often. And if you look at your Chromebook's keyboard, you probably will notice it doesn't have a delete key. And you go, wait a minute, you mean you can't delete anything in a Chrome? No, you can. Okay, there's three ways to delete things that I use quite often. One is you can use the backspace, so click behind a word or click on an app or whatever and use the backspace, and it kind of takes it out. If you literally want the delete key, then you can go Alt backspace, and what that does is that is actually the delete key is Alt backspace. Okay, and let's see, what's another shortcut that I use? Ooh, here, let me close off this for a second. Notice that we're using a full screen for the browser. What if you have multiple applications or a lot of different work working on your Chromebook like I do? You can go Alt bracket, and then what that does is that will shove your work over to one side so you can bring over other work and do other work there on that other side of the screen. So remember, that's Alt bracket. The Alt left bracket will shove your work over to the left. The Alt right bracket will shove your work over to the right. So let's get another window here opened. And let's just say here that I have some of my work. So I go Alt right bracket. There we go. Now it's divided into two parts. There's the left and the right. Easy to do. Remember that shortcut is Alt bracket to divide your work up there. So let's maximize this again now. All right. Again, it's Control Alt question mark to bring up the shortcut to all of the shortcuts there for your Chromebook. These are listed by different categories. So the very first one there is popular shortcuts. Of course, you got the all popular Control C and Control V. So the nice thing to know is that all of the shortcuts that you were used to using in a Microsoft Word environment, they carry over perfectly into the Chromebook. So there they are. And I do want to say a big thank you to all of my subscribers who have sent in all of these suggestions for this video. So that's a big shout out to you guys. Thank you there for asking that in your comments. All right, so when we go down, next one here is tabs and windows. So there's the shortcuts for those. And you can find in there, for example, that Alt bracket. That's really, really useful. Next, there's the page and web browser shortcuts that pertaining to that. And usually I don't go about and just memorize all of the thousands of shortcuts that you have. I just basically memorize the ones that are most useful, the ones I use every day. For example, caps lock again, that's your Alt search. One of the ones I would recommend remembering is the Control Alt question mark to bring up the list so you can find your other shortcuts there. So here's text editing. And then, wow, some of these are rather long shortcuts, but you can do so many things with these shortcuts. Remember, these are all, they're considered keyboard shortcuts. If you look at your keyboard on your Chromebook, at the very top, you notice that we have some, there are function keys there, and but they're not F1 through F11 like you would find on a Windows machine. They're different, right? And so the very first one there is Escape. Then you have these two ones that have arrows on them. That's to go back and forth between your browser windows. So the very first one there is to go back to previously visited websites or web pages. And then the other arrow key is to go forward. The next one is Refresh. and let's say you're looking at news or weather, and it didn't update the weather for you, you'd hit the refresh key. That's the one that looks like a little arrow going around, and that will refresh your browser window. And then we have another one that's the full screen. So notice my screen went up to maximize, so we might call that the maximize icon there. Hit it again and it brings it down, so you see your tools, you see your icons and your apps at the bottom, you see your shelf, other things there are viewable for you there. The next one there, if I click it there or hold it down, you'll see the different applications that you're running. And I don't have any other applications running. I'm just videotaping this as well as the browser. So that's why that doesn't show up. If you had other apps running, they would all be in line there. The next one are, they look like a small sun and the big sun. That's the dim and the brighten key. So if you wanted to dim, there you go. Notice how it gets real dark, and then get it bright again. Just click on the sun icon or the bright icon, and that gets it brighter. There you go. And the next one there is mute. And click it again there, and it's unmuted there. And you have the volume control, and then the very last one is the power button. Now, just to let you know, if for some reason that your Chromebook, you turn on your Chromebook and it's all black screened, you know, it doesn't seem like it turns on, but you look on the side of your Chromebook and you have a little light, it may be amber or maybe a yellow, red, or blue, depending on the model of your Chromebook. But if you look on the side of your Chromebook, you have that light is on, but the screen is not on. You press and you hold that power button for about 3 to 5 seconds. The computer will restart and then will come up to the operating system. It actually will reboot for you. So you have that button there. That's how we use it in case the machine has a problem. You long press the power button. On some Chromebooks, you have the power button on the side as well. And if you do have the button, a power button on the side, please use that one if your machine doesn't seem to turn on. Now, if for some reason your screen is black, it doesn't turn on, but you don't have any lights at all along the sides of your Chromebook, something may be wrong with your charger. So unplug the charger and then plug it back in, maybe to a different wall socket, or use a different charger there. Usually the newer Chromebooks, they're all USB Type-C, which is a universal type of charger there, or plug that you can find. All right. Hey, so there you have it. Now you know of the shortcuts and how to find the shortcuts on a Chromebook, and hopefully you find that useful. And if you like these types of videos, please click on that thumbs up, share the video, as it really helps the channel greatly when you share or even click on thumbs up. And if you have a question or anything else that you have related to technology, Chromebooks, electric vehicles, or maybe you have an idea for a future video, go ahead and leave that down in the comments, and I will really consider those as well and answer those too. Alrighty, thank you very much for watching to the end of the video. And this last shot that we see here is actually the night shot that we see out of our window there of the family house, which is a beautiful night shot there of the night sky. Alrighty, thank you again, and bye-bye.